हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। प्रेस द सब्सक्राइब बटन लाइक दिस एंड देन यू हैव टू टैप द बेल आइकन एडजेसेंट टू द सब्सक्राइब बटन लाइक दिस एंड देन यू विल गेट द नोटिफिकेशन फ्रॉम माय चैनल।
हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग यू व्हाट इज अ ब्लास्ट फर्नेस, इट्स वेरियस पार्ट्स and the complete working and its applications. So let's start with the video. Here on the screen you can see a cross-sectional view of a typical blast furnace that is common across the world in order to produce pig iron. So blast furnace, its main application is to produce pig iron, and after producing pig iron we use other processes and other furnaces and add carbon in order to produce different steels. But here in blast furnace, what its main role is to produce pig iron. So pig iron is the most raw form of iron. Now let's see various parts. So the blast furnace, it's divided into four basic zones. From the bottom we have hearth, then bosh, then stack, and then top. So the furnace is divided into four zones: top, stack, bosh, and hearth. We have a internal stainless steel cylinder. So this is like complete from here up till like all this. So this is the stainless steel internal. So this is a 2D cross sectional view, but you imagine this as a cylinder. So the cylinder, it is tapered towards the top. So this is like slightly tapered, it's not perpendicular, it's not vertical, it's tapered towards the top. And then we have around 5 to 6 inches of refractory lining. Refractory lining means it is composed of bricks. So brick layer is there or all around the furnace. So brick, it will act as a thermal insulator and also provide rigidity and structural support to the furnace. So this refractory lining, it is all across. See, this is the refractory lining. This complete is the refractory lining. So this will provide structural support to the furnace as well as it will provide thermal insulation so that the heat inside, it will not go outside. Okay, then we have other thing that is known as blast pipe. So blast pipe, its function is to supply very hot air that is preheated in order to enhance combustion process. Then we have tire. Tire is, so in some of the furnaces we will find a tire, in some of the furnaces we won't find tire. So tire will help in adding few of additional components like phosphorus or tungsten or carbon, any other material that we want to add. So we will add along with the preheated air through this tire. Then at the bottom most we have the bed. So bed will act as a complete structural support. It will take the load of the entire furnace. So this has to take the entire load of the components along with the furnace weight. So that is the bed. Now let's see how its working is. So on the top we feed three things. Basically we feed iron ore, we feed iron ore plus we feed limestone, we feed limestone plus we feed coke. So only three things we feed here in this small bell and large bell. So in large bell we basically feed iron ore and limestone, and in a small bell we feed coke, because around 80% of the components that we feed. So these three are the raw materials in order to produce pig iron. So iron ore, suppose we have to produce 1 ton of pig iron, so iron ore we have to take around 1.5 tons. Okay, limestone we will take around 0.4 tons and coke we will take around 0.1 ton. Okay, so these are the raw materials, and that too in a small bell and large bell. So in large bell we will feed iron ore plus limestone, and in a small bell we will feed coke. So all these three materials, it will come here. Okay, So those are the raw materials. Then what we do, we light up the furnace. So to in order to start the furnace, first we put in very hot preheated air. So preheated air enhanced with oxygen. So sometime we use oxygen in order to enhance combustion initially only, or sometimes we provide additional oxygen afterwards. But the blast furnace itself means that we are providing a blast of air in order to enhance combustion. So that is the basic difference between this furnace and other type of furnaces, that here we are blasting furnace, blasting like supplying a hot air at high pressure and high temperature. So the furnace, so the raw materials, it will get, it will pick up the heat from this combustion process. So the overall temperature reached, it's around 3000 degrees Celsius. So this will provide heat from the bottom to this raw material, that is limestone, iron ore and coke. So coke will help in further enhancing the combustion process to provide heat to the iron ore. So finally what happens, all the iron ore along with coke, along with limestone, they melt and form a layer across the from bottom to top. So the heaviest metal, that is iron, so it settles at the bottom. Then comes next layer, that is like oxides and other magnesite and all those things, impurities. Then comes the unburned carbon, or like unburned carbon and oxides further, which are lighter in weight, they will move further up. So we will see various layers, okay, and the bottommost, that is of important to us, so that is pig iron. So that will settle down. So see here, it's the molten iron, molten slag and molten iron. So finally the molten iron, that is having the highest density, it will settle down at the bottom. Okay, and all the flue gases, so flue gases are the unburnt gases which are not which are produced during the chemical reaction processes. So they will move to the top because they are very lighter, and all the hot flue gases, so flue gases, FLUE, these are like impurity gases carrying away the impurity, and these are produced due to the exothermic reaction happening inside the furnace. So the chemical reactions happening, those produce flue gases. So these flue gases, they go, and we have these chambers on the sides. These will act as like a ventilators. So the flue gases, they go out from the top and they are not rejected to the atmosphere. Remember these. Another, we have filters and separators here also. So those are known as flue gas separators or flue gas entrapters. So they will catch this flue gas and try to convert all the particles inside the flue gas in form of solids, and then those solids, then they are discarded or thrown away. Okay, so the flue gases, it will rise up. We have different layers of the formation based on the density. So the lighter slag and other things, impurities, they will form the topmost layer. Then comes the unburnt carbon and the unburnt pig iron, and then the molten iron, which is of importance to us. So we have to finally have this molten iron, that is the pig iron. So we have to get this as a product, output product. So we have a top hole, that is known as top hole. Okay, so from top hole, we will open this top hole periodically in order to tap the molten iron. So molten iron, because of the weight of the and because of the gravity, it will automatically flow out. Once you open this hole, so it will automatically flow out, and this molten metal, this molten pig iron, it is collected and created in form of ingots. So ingot is the right term for pig iron. So if you say break or a block of pig iron, that will not make correct sense. In metallurgy we call it ingots. So ingot, so we will create cuboids. Okay, so we will create cuboid shape pig irons, those are known as ingots, and these are further sent to other industries or to create steel. So the raw material to produce steel is pig iron, but to produce pig iron we need a blast furnace in which we use limestone, coke as well as iron ore as our raw material. So now let's see the overall flow chart. So here on the screen you can see the flow chart. I'll explain. So here we have in the blast furnace, so this is till here we have the blast furnace, and here we got the pig iron. So this is the output. So afterwards, like pig iron, it can be casted into three types, that is simple iron, like iron ingot, pig iron ingots, or like further addition of phosphorus and sulfur and other materials in order to create malleable iron, or chilled iron. Okay, otherwise this pig iron, it can be further purified in order to create carbon steel. So carbon steel, it's used in various other industries, and this is produced using basic oxygen process. If we are using a Bessemer converter taking the raw material as pig iron, then we will be producing Bessemer steel. If we are using basic open hearth furnace, then we will create finally output as basic open steel. If we are using electric furnace, then we will be creating tool steel. If we are using acid open hearth furnace, then we will be getting acid open steel. If we are using crucible furnace, we will be getting crucible steel. And if we are finally using puddling process, then we will be getting wrought iron. Okay, so fine. In pig iron, also remember the impurities are carbon, magnesium, phosphorus, sulfur and silicon. So these five impurities are there. So first of all, we have to, in order to produce steel, so steel, you know, it's an alloy in which basic raw material we will be using is pig iron, but we have to remove these impurities and add additional pure components. Like, depending on the percentage of carbon, we decide the type of steel. So those are like different processes. So remember, using blast furnace you never produce steel. So most of the people have doubt that we produce steel also. No, we only produce pig iron, and that pig iron, it is further used as a raw material in other processes, in other furnaces, in cupola furnace or crucible furnace or electric furnace or Bessemer converter, in order to produce steel. So I hope this video was very helpful to you. If you have found the video helpful, please like and share this video, and if you are new to this channel, please subscribe and press the notification bell. I would be seeing you in the next such video. Till then, take care.